Hi, Namaste. Welcome back to another interesting topic of our English class. Guys, today we are going to discuss a very important topic, that is preposition. And you all know, preposition is a word that shows the relation between a noun or a pronoun and other words in a sentence. So, preposition is placed before a noun or a pronoun. So, guys, let's look some of the commonly used preposition and its use.
Before discussing each preposition, just go through this image. And this image shows the preposition of position, and you people can clearly understand the preposition based on the position of that cat. At first, just look at the first picture. The cat is in the box. Next one, cat is on the box. Then cat is under the box. Then in front of. Cat is in front of the box. Then next two, above. Then below, between. On the left, opposite. On the right. All these preposition shows the position. So position of preposition. Then let's look the preposition one by one. At. The preposition at is commonly used before a place. For example, at home, at the office, at that building, at mountain. So at is commonly used before a small place. The next one, at is used before a small town. The preposition at is used before a small town. For example, at Parashala, at Nemam, at Nayatingara. In this way, we can use the preposition at before a small town. Then, at is commonly used before a point of time. Time, for example, at 10 o'clock, at 6:30. At night. So at is used before a time. The next one, at is used before the names of festivals. For example, at Onam, at Christmas, at Vishu, at Ramadan. So at is used before the names of some festivals. Then we can use the preposition at before the qualities or abilities. To mention or just before a quality or ability, we can use the preposition at. For example, she is good at singing. He is good at tennis. So in this way, we can use the preposition at before a quality or ability. Then we can use the at before the pronoun me. For example, look at me. Don't look at me that way. In this way, we can use the preposition at before the preposition me. So I repeat, we use the preposition before a place and before a small town, and to mention time, before the names of festivals, before the qualities or abilities, and before the pronoun me. In. The preposition in is commonly used before any places, countries, big cities, month, year, and seasons. First one, places. Preposition in is used before any places. For example, I am in school. Then in can use before some countries. For example, in America, in Japan. Then it can used before big cities. For example, in Trivandrum, in Kerala. In this way, we can use the preposition in. Then in can used before month. For example, in April, in March, in July. In this way, the preposition in can use. Then It can be used before season. For example, in winter, in summer, in autumn. So I repeat, the preposition in is commonly used before any places, countries, big cities, month, year and season, and it can also be used before or used to mention the position of a particular thing. On, the preposition on is used to express the surface of something. For example, on the table, on the book. So in this way, we can use the preposition on to express surface of something. Then on is used before days and dates. For example, on Sunday, on Monday, on Onam Day, on 2nd October. In this way, we can use the preposition on before days and dates. Next one, on is used to indicate part of the body, our body parts. So, the preposition on is used to indicate the part of the body. For example, that ball hit me on my shoulder. Mother kissed me on my cheek. So, in this way, we can use the preposition on to indicate part of the body. 2. The preposition to is used to indicate direction. For example, I go to school. She goes to Mumbai. So, to indicate direction, we use the preposition to. The next one, if we want to convert a verb into infinitive, we need to add the preposition to just before that verb. For example, I go to school to study. Here, we add the preposition to just before the verb study. So, if we want to convert a verb into infinitive, we need to add the preposition to just before that verb. To study, to learn, to play, I want to play, upon. The word meaning of the preposition upon is very similar to the meaning of the word on, but we use the preposition upon to mention something in the sense being above. For example, there is a crown upon his head. Then, if we want to mention something being supported by another, we use the preposition upon. For example, the crew set sail upon the sea. Then, we use the preposition upon at a prescribed point. For example, your success depends upon whether you work hard or not. Of. Of is a commonly used preposition. We use the preposition of to mention something belong to or relating to or connected with. For example, the first page of the book describes the author's profile. Then, the secret of this game is very interesting. Then, we use the preposition of to indicate an amount or number. For example, she drinks 2 cups of tea. Cups of tea. Here, the preposition is used to indicate an amount, right? Then, a large number of people gathered. I had only 4 hours of sleep during the last 2 days. So in this sentence, the preposition of, O-F, of, is used to indicate an amount or number.
So I hope you all understood this topic very well. So thank you guys. See you in the next class.